Ohio State is able to beat USC and win third ever RFL College Series National Championship. That being said, Pecan, give us a breakdown. Why are these your 10 top teams?
So I think it's obvious why I put at number one and number two. I think Ohio State and Miami, they have the most prospects coming into this year. And as always, Ohio State and Miami are bringing back a bunch of great talent, so I thought I had to put them at one and two.
Well, number one, I do have Ohio State. Number two is Alabama, though. And I'll explain why I have certain teams where they are, especially Alabama, why some people will probably say, why you got them over Miami? All right, so game one. Of course, the favorites is Ohio State. They're expected to win by 11 or more points. Of course, you going with Ohio State all day, man. You think they get it done by 11 or more points?
Teams, I think TCU keeps it close, but I wouldn't be shocked if Ohio State does win it by two or by at least two. Ohio State, with the amount of talent that they brought in this year, you know, they have Kentaro Sheffield, they have new wide receivers, and Steve McCaskill, and is it Kingston Bryan? Kingston Bryson, yes. But he has looked really good from the scrimmages we have seen. This guy, Arturo Flores, look out for him to make some moves because he looks really, really good. But I know there's an RFL team that is waiting to see the debut of a guy, of an RFL player's brother, Drew Brewer's brother, mm-hmm. Seth Brewer. We are starting the whole Joey and Nick Bosa thing at Ohio
crazy.
State.
We didn't even bring him up for new prospects to look out for. I mean, yeah. That was our top three, though. Like, but, man, I completely just blanked on that. Like, He's definitely.
I was
up
also
there.
trying not to choose nothing but Ohio State guys for all of the guys, you know.
And then we move into the final game of the week. This was game of the week. It was a great game, but Penn State was able to separate, and we got to play the bell because this raises the question now here, guys. This definitely raises a question from what it is titled on the podcast, right? Do you guys think we're going to have a new champion? I mean, it's always hard to be able to repeat, period, get back to the playoffs, all that. But for Ohio State, they've been good front runners, but already two losses up to this point in four games. Two losses in four games. They're obviously not looking the same as they were the last couple of years when they won those back-to-back national championships. It was a rough going for Dylan Lewis. It looks like when Dylan Lewis isn't clicking, that's when they're losing games. He threw five interceptions in their last loss, three in this one. And, man, Penn State, they put it on them 30-16, beat them by two scores, 14 points. It definitely looks like Ohio State, they just aren't the same team. They might not make it to the playoffs, man. I mean, two losses, that's usually your max. They lose any more than this, well, I think they lose another game, they're done. They got a chance, of course, to potentially win, but I don't know. I really do get the vibes. See some guys saying new champions. In my take, I don't think that Ohio State makes it back to the playoffs. I really don't, like, especially with the situation with them changing their defense to 3-4. Even before then, they really weren't getting that pressure or being that dominant of a defense as they were before. And to make it more out of their personnel, I think it's going to really give them problems moving forward this season. I do see them potentially dropping another game, honestly. And not to say that they can't go undefeated up to this point. They can do that. They still have good talent. There's pretty much everyone with two losses right now is just about out. I don't see them making that change or being better than the teams that's in the top nine right now. And that includes Ohio State now all the way down to 15, which is tough for them. But for the college series, hey, I'm pretty sure most people enjoying it because we want to see a new champion, right? Two times back-to-back national champions. They did their thing, that's for sure. This year, things looking much different. Ohio State versus Iowa. But, man, OSU, don't lose this game. Do not lose this game. Ohio State, I got them by 8 or more points. I think they beat them by more than a touchdown. Iowa, hey, they got their first win of the season. They only beat Maryland, though, who, like I said, started out good, but they're showing us their true colors. They were never that good to begin with. And I think Ohio State gets their bounce back game here. And I think they beat Iowa pretty good.
Scared of my own immaturity, scared of my own ceiling, scared I'll die of uncertainty, fear might be the death of me, fear leads to anxiety, don't know what's inside of me, don't forget about me, don't forget about me, even when I doubt you, I'm no good without you. Temperatures dropping, I'm not sure if I can see this ever stopping, shaking hands with the dark parts of my thoughts, no, you are all that I've got, no, don't forget about me. Gnawing on the bishops, claw away of this system, repeating simple phrases. Someone wholly insisted, want the markings made on my skin to mean something to me again. Hope you haven't left without me. Hope you haven't left without me, please. Don't forget about me. No.
fans are stripping all these cats down in their underoos.
sip of something poison, but I hold on tight. Yeah, it's okay.
Third down, run inside, and they will get it. Game over. Oklahoma is going to pull through for the upset.
Oppressed. Ooh, it's like a dream. What she feels with. It's the game, and it's the best rivalry in college football.
If you grew up a Buckeye, if you grew up in the great state of Ohio, or if you are a Buckeye now, this is the real one. This is the greatest rivalry in all of sport. Not college football, all of sport.
Three things. Number one, the team that hits the hardest and the longest. The team that starts the fastest. And the team is too damn smart to make mistakes.
I stand before you with much respect. You're waiting for your assignment, your mission directive. Here it is. Rely on each other. Love each other as hard as you've ever played.
If you take it to them and you keep taking it to them, hell, there's no question who will win.
To burn it down.
one, Big Ten Conference Championship. Talked about this. Ohio State, last time they lost was against Penn State way back in week 5. And Penn State embarrassed you guys. I mean, it was 30-16. I'm going with Ohio State for the get back here. I think the Buckeyes, especially with the way Penn State has looked lately, unless we get that old school Penn State, because if we get that coming into this game, that's going to be pretty crazy. I think that, that's what makes me excited about this game, right? Because at any moment, you never know when a team's going to get back to rare form. And Penn State, when they were in rare form this season, they were doing teams dirty. And they were actually putting up really good performances. Do I have that much faith in Sean Clifford? No, because he's not really that scrambling style in which he's been doing this season. It hasn't been working with him in the later end. And this Ohio State defense has stepped his game up to a whole, to step their game up to a whole nother level now with getting the pressure in the sacks, which you talked about. And so I'm going with the Buckeyes by 5 or more points. I believe that is the biggest spread I've got out of any of the games in the conference championship games.
You're special, you do. I can see it in your eyes. I can see it when you laugh at me. Look down on me and walk around on me. Just one more fight about your leadership. And I will straight up.
You got
This is a great game. I think if Baylor can put together the same type of offense and stuff like they did last time, and if their defense, the defense needs to be much better as well, because if they allow Ohio State's offense to get comfortable and then you got Karate Kid out here actually throwing touchdowns early, that's going to be a problem. Baylor's not going to win. So their defense needs to step up. Baylor's defense for the last 3 to 4 weeks has not been able to stop a nosebleed. For that, in this matchup and the experience that Ohio State has, I'm going to take the Buckeyes to win by 4 or more points. Same as, you know, LSU in their matchup against Oregon. It's just Ohio State has too much working right now. Defense is now clicking, has been clicking for more than half the season now, if you include this conference championship win over Penn State. And that's a lot of pressure to put on Jordan Granger, right? He had to be perfect just to win against Oklahoma. I don't even know if he's perfect, if that's going to be able to work out against Ohio State. So I'm going to go ahead and take the Buckeyes in this one. Time for the final game to determine who's going to be playing LSU in the national championship. To advance to the national championship, will it be Ohio State for the third consecutive time, or will Baylor pull off the unimaginable?
Give me a shot at the night. Give me a shot at the night. I feel like give me a shot at the night. Some kind of mysterious. Give me a shot at
Baylor's
the
gonna
night.
Hunt it. They're faking it. Throws. Oh my goodness, he dropped the ball.
Give me a shot at the night.
But yeah, I guess this leads right into it. CS5 National Championship Week. Will Ohio State three-peat? Now, obviously, we know your answer. Right. Yeah, for me, you got to go with the guys who've done it twice. You know, I'm gonna be completely honest. Do I want to see Ohio State win three? No. I like seeing new champions. I like seeing new guys make it happen. So I'm actually in favor of LSU. I would like LSU to win the national championship. It'll be a great ending. But at the same time, I know what Ohio State has formed into now, and you can't. There's no way I could go with LSU, even as great as they looked against Oregon and how close Ohio State was to losing that first round. I can't go against the guys who've won two back-to-back national championships. So I'm taking Ohio State in this one by a field goal.
Oh, last year, their first year with Aiden, they go 7-6, but he got some, you know, he got two big-time quality guys to buy into his system. You know, to buy into what he's trying to do, and getting a real life running back in John Emery. I mean, and how about these guys, man? These guys have been studs for him the whole entire year. Vince Monroe, Larry Ford, Marius Ponzi, Heath Ball. All of these guys are generics who can be drafted. You know, and either one of them, if Payne isn't on his best game, one of these guys will. And the defense this year for LSU, I mean, I truly believe, Smitty, that this defense has been better than Miami. Now, Miami's probably two or three, but in my opinion, from what I've seen the whole entire year and the stats that I just gave to you, this, in my opinion, is the best defense the whole entire year. You got Frank Shelby, the defensive end. Yanni Ramirez has been a stud for them the whole entire year.
I think they are the number one defense, man. You know, since we have to make, you know, predictions, since we don't have all the numbers, I mean, I really do think that this is the number one defense. And this is, again, you know, we talk about, you know, guys always referencing, you know, defense wins championships. That's the thing that's, you know, is known across. But you got to have the offense to back it too. And that's what makes LSU really scary in this national championship game, man. They have the offense clicking right now. And as for Ohio State, you guys have brought Charles' defense up to a whole new level here late towards the second half of the season. But this is where I feel LSU has a shot. What is Dylan Lewis going to do? That's going to be the issue. This probably is not going to be the game where he can sit up here and throw three interceptions and his defense helps him finish out and they become a three-time national championship team. He is going to have to be on his A game like he was in that game against Baylor, because he threw three touchdowns, no interceptions. He was doing his thing. He needs to have a performance like that next week against LSU. Again, just even the stat line that you talked about, there hasn't been a single team all season long to score over or score even touch 30 points. Against this LSU defense, and they average 16 giving up a game.
Break me down. I'm the man. Come. when I take the stand. Who's the man? Who's the man? Who's the man? Who's the man?
Ball game. The Ohio State Buckeyes have done it once again. Three-time national champions, back to back to back.